The EV Michigan Road Trip, sponsored by LaFontaine Ford Grand Rapids.
Our EV Michigan road trip is in Detroit now, and one of the most common myths surrounding electric vehicles is they're actually worse for the environment. We've gotten several viewer questions about it. Meteorologist Samantha Jacks joins us live now from the Motor City, and Sam, you spoke to several experts about this. What did you find out?
Yeah, Juliet, this is something that I'm very passionate about and looked into it in great detail. Electric vehicles are very different from internal combustion vehicles in that they do not have engines. And the batteries that are used in EVs do have a very large environmental footprint, but in comparison to a regular car, they still perform better. Let's take a look.
As electric vehicles become more popular, there are concerns that they are not as environmentally friendly as promised. We spoke to several experts who have spent the last 10 years studying the environmental impacts of EVs who say otherwise.
Driving the average electric vehicle produces about half the emissions of driving the average gasoline vehicle.
So then where does this misconception come from?
From a life cycle perspective, electric vehicles have a much lower impact than a gasoline vehicle.
Key term, life cycle. At the start of making an EV, they're actually worse for the environment due to the battery making process.
Batteries is really the biggest difference between the two vehicles. So we look really closely at battery manufacturing. And it turns out that is more energy intensive, more pollution associated with making the batteries than making the gasoline vehicle.
So brand new, off the lot, EVs actually do have more emissions and pollutions associated with them. But it doesn't take long for that statistic to change.
But because when you're operating it, it's so much cleaner, over time, you're going to essentially, the EV will be cleaner. A passenger vehicle EV, roughly, but within 2 years of driving that vehicle, you will make up for the difference in emissions. And then after that, you are in the clear.
This is because gas-powered vehicles are emitting pollutions every day you drive it, and the level of pollution associated with the extraction of oil and refining of gasoline.
And that's assuming the average grid, the average electricity grid. If you have solar on your roof or you're powering it with renewable energy, you're choosing that through your utility provider, the more benefits you're going
to
get.
To take this one step further, EV batteries can be repurposed and recycled.
An electric vehicle reaches the end of its life after, say, 10 to 15 years. Before recycling, actually, the battery can be repurposed, and the battery can then be used for stationary storage. So this means that it could be used to support solar arrays. It can charge in the middle of the day and then release in the evening when there isn't as much electricity being generated. And then, as you mentioned, recycling, all of the batteries can be recycled, no matter if they were repurposed or if they weren't.
Now, their study went on to say that a regular car would need to get 91 miles per gallon to equal the global warming emissions of an electric vehicle, completely debunking the myth that EVs are just as bad for the environment as ICE vehicles. Juliet.
Sam, thank you for that live report and the interesting information. And if you have a question, text the word CAR to 616-559-1310 and follow along on our EV road trip on air and as well as our website, 13onyourside.com.